Graves, technical advisor at Sega Manufacturing. You can reach me directly at area code 815-801-1178 or by email at vgraves@sega.com. That's vgraves@sega.com. My contact info is located below throughout this video. Today we're going to be discussing our startup and training guide for the LV2018 Lean Vendor Beverage Machine. The first thing you'll do when you open your machine is remove your power cord. That plugs into a receptacle in the back of the machine and goes into the wall. You'll also need to install your leg levelers into the bottom of the machine using a 1.5-inch wrench. Anytime you're moving the machine from your protective skid that it's shipped with after the leg levelers have been put on, you want to make sure you're using a forklift or a pallet jack to lift it up and move it so that you don't damage those legs. We'd also like to discuss the components of our outer door system. We have our two display windows, top and bottom, our LED selection buttons, numbered 1 through 9 for the top row and 10 through 18 along the bottom row, our two delivery openings, top and bottom. As we move to the side, we've got our blue LCD display, our bill acceptor and credit card machine. Below that, we've got our coin input slot and our coin return button. Below that, we've got our coin return cup. Over on the left, we have our T-handle and our locking cylinder. To open our outer door, we turn our T-handle counterclockwise. Once you open your outer door, you can see your service door. You'll see your loading diagram, the best reference tool with a list of all of the approved drinks that have been tested here, along with how they're loaded, a list of the proper shims and accessories. Below that, we have our delivery doors for top and bottom. Below that, we have our two refrigeration vents. These need to be kept clean to maximize airflow. Our door switch. On the right side of our service door, you'll see the locking latch that opens the inner door. The two doors will separate, and we can see our inner service door. On the front, we have our wiring diagram, as well as our two delivery chutes with their doors. On the inside of your outer door, you'll find your LED strips, your two display windows, your two delivery chutes. On the left side, you'll find your control board with your blue service menu button on the lower right. Below that, you'll find your bill acceptor and coin machine, your telemetry device, and below that is your coin overflow bucket, as well as the door switch again. To change out the flavor cards in your display window, you simply remove the two blue thumb screws. Once you've removed your blue thumb screws, simply pull the live display back. Your flavor cards slide in and out of the wells very simply. Just bend your card, place it inside the well. The entire display folds forward and replace your blue thumb screws. Inside of your outer door, you'll find your delivery system. Here we have our retainer clips, our motors and motor harnesses, our vibration sensors, identical setups for top and bottom. Below that, we have our cooling deck. We have our condenser on the left, something that needs to be kept clean. Over on the right, we have our red on and off switch, as well as our 24 amp breaker. Your first two selections, the first two columns in both the top and the lower system, are tied together as a space to sail feature. So the first button on the outside of the machine, as well as the 10th button on the second row, both control these two lanes. You'll want to put your top selling beverage in these lanes. You have the up capacity possibilities with the space to sale feature. This is your cooling deck. It comes out of your machine very simply. There's one screw in the base of your machine. It's all mounted to this steel tray, and the entire unit slides out as one. You have your condenser with your condenser fan, your compressor, your evaporator and evaporator fans, your evaporation chamber, condenser pan. Here we have our two relays that run our compressor and condenser, as well as our evaporator fans, all located here. Within your beverage lanes, you have several options for spacers and shims, depending on the product that you're vending. Here we have all of the available shims and spacers, starting with our back spacer, our large side spacer, our small side spacer, the right side spacer, the auger insert, and the auger that it snaps into. Anytime we're going to remove a motor or a harness or anything that has to do with our control board or our cooling deck, we want to make sure that our machine is powered off. The simplest way to do that is to flip this red switch and turn our power off. Now that our machine is powered down, we can take a look at our shims and our motor assemblies. Our retainer clip operates very simply. You pull up to unlock it and it will fold forward for our loading purposes. This needs to be a half an inch away from the rear drink in the lane. So you simply decide which tab is closest, drop it down, and lock it in. Certain products, it may be simpler to remove this retainer clip altogether. With your retainer clip removed, you can see your full view of your drink lane. Inside, you'll see in this one, we have a small side spacer attached to the left side wall with a three-tab system. We have three tabs with three corresponding openings in the left lane, and they simply slide in and drop. Now that we have the small side spacer out, we can remove our motor. To do this, we want to start by unhooking our wire harness. Now we again have two blue thumb screws, top and bottom, on our mounting bracket. Once we've removed our blue thumb screws, we can pull our motor off, using one hand to catch the auger as it comes unseated from our motor. Our motor and its mounting bracket come off simply. Now we can pull our auger directly through the opening, showing our empty drink lane. Here we have our right side spacer, used with slim cans. Unlike the left side spacers, this one has two tabs that go in flat in the lane to corresponding slots. I found that this one is a little simpler to install without the auger coming from the bottom up. When you come in from the bottom, you'll find your two slotted tabs, and they snap in very easily. Here we have our auger and our auger insert. The inserts snap into the augers using their two plastic tabs. They simply slide in, and you can hear an audible pop as they're pushed in snug to the auger. The small PEM goes to the rear with the long one going to the front mounted to the motor. It's very important when we replace our auger that our PEM is fully seated and our black rubber grommet in the rear of the lane. We can place our auger back through our opening and run it back to get our PEM seated in our rubber grommet. I keep it stable with one hand Now I can put my motor back on, insert the PEM into the gear, line up my PEMs, then I can put my blue thumb screws back on. Now I can put my wire harness back in. And my motor's back on. Once our proper accessories have been installed and our motor is reassembled, we can load our drinks and then replace our retainer clip. Again, approximately a half an inch or a finger's width from the last drink. Find the tab that works best, pull it up, and draw up your locking tab. And now you're ready to test vent. Our lighted LED buttons are used when inside the service menu to access your diagnostic and programming settings. Our buttons are numbered 1 through 9 on the top row, and the buttons used inside the programming are 6, 7, 8, and 9. Your sixth button is for abort or to go backwards. Your 7 and 8 buttons scroll up and down through the menu options. And number 9 is like an enter key. It saves and moves forward. To access the service menu in your machine, first we need to open the door. Then we'll open our inner door. And we'll press the blue service menu button in the bottom right corner of our control board. Once you're in your service menu, the first thing that will come up on your display will be any errors. You can press the 9 key to enter and display any of your errors. 6 will take you back. Buttons 7 and 8 scroll up and down throughout the menu. Some of our used menu options will be a return to sales. By pressing enter, the machine will go back to its sales mode. You can also simply close the door and you will go back to sales mode as well. Password, test modes. We use 9 to enter and we can scroll through to do a test vend to test our relays, both on our lights and our cooling system. The most used option inside your test mode section will be to perform a test vend. We press enter on test vend and then we can scroll up or down to choose which selection we would like to spin. Once we hit enter, that selection will spin one time. So selection 3 will spin when I hit the enter button. You'll be able to hear the motor. And see the auger spin. That's how you perform a test vent. Tube fill is the mode you'll need to be in when you want to prime your changer. You'll go into tube fill and enter your coins at the front of the machine, giving your control board the chance to get an accurate count of how much change is in your change machine. Coin payout is used to empty the coins in a particular tube. Password. Some of our service menu options are protected by a password. So if we press enter there, your password is 7869. 7869. Once we've entered our password, we have our cash counters, which is a count of all of our monetary transactions. Our sales counters, which keep track of how many vends we've made. The pricing program, this is where we go in to enter our prices. Right now this machine is set at single price, which means every item in the machine is set at one price. We can also change it to multi-price by turning that setting on, and then set each individual price the same. Once we're in our price settings, we can scroll up or down to change the pricing on our machine and hit enter to save. Exact change is a setting you can use to set the exact amount of change and coins left in your change machine for when the machine will scroll its exact change message. Timed programming is where you'll enter events when you need pre-timed shutdown periods, particularly in schools when the machine needs to be down at certain times of the day. There's 32 separate intervals that can be programmed. Lighting control, you can set times when your lights will not be on if you're in 24-hour locations that would like the lights to dim or shut off during certain times of the day. Refrigeration is where we can go in and turn our cooling on or off, choose whether to scroll our temperature during our welcome message, have our set point, and change our degrees from Fahrenheit to Celsius. And of course, we have our return to sales mode. Again, we can scroll with our 7 and 8 buttons. Options, this is where we can turn our multi-price system on or off, depending on if we want to set our machine all at one price or every item differently. We can turn our point of service message, what scrolls when we're in sales mode, on or off. We can set it so all of our reports, our cash counters, and our vending counters will reset every time we open or close the door. That will clear all of our DEX information. You can turn that option on or off, so you can reset them manually or every time the machine is opened. Credit clear, for if we are in multi-vend mode, how long the credit will stay if the people do not hit their coin return button and get their change and it's stored in there. Whether that clears after a certain amount of time or stays until the next vend. Force vend, if this is turned on, once money is inserted in the machine, a vend has to be made before they can get any change. They cannot get a full refund. Multi-vend on or off that we discussed. In multi-vend, when this is turned on, if I enter $2 to make a $1.50 purchase, it will hold my 50 cents as credit, and I will have the opportunity to either make another purchase or add more money or hit the coin return button to get my change back. This will give your customer the opportunity to make an additional purchase. If we turn that off, as soon as the vend is made, the change will automatically be put into the coin return. Bill escrow is a feature where your bill acceptor will hold the last bill that was placed in before it gets put into the bill box so that it can eject it as change. Free vend, if that is turned on, everything in your machine is now free. Shock sensitivity is how you change the settings on your shock sensor for each delivery system. We do ask that you call customer care before you make any changes to these settings, as they've been tested specifically here in the factory before they get to you. And back to multi-price. Again, we can hit back to go through any of the listed options below. 9 is the enter key to go in. This machine, just from us in our testing phase here, has been tested with $3 so far. We can go to our vend modes, check our sales counters, all through our 6, 7, 8, and 9 buttons. And again, we can choose our return to sales options or simply close the door and get our welcome message again. So that was a quick guide to your LV2018 machine. If you ever have any vending errors or things that are multi-vending or not dropping, make sure you first consult your loading diagram. Make sure that the product that you're loading has the correct accessory group and that they are loaded properly. And perform your test vends. Make sure there aren't any drinks that have become stuck or lodged in your delivery system. You can turn these augers by hand if you have something that is stuck between the auger and the sidewall, a drink that you have to get out. You can usually pull them out by turning the auger manually. If you can't get it out that way, you can drop your retainer clip, pull your products out, and reach it from the top. Or else we've discussed how easy it is to pull the motor and the auger if you have to empty the entire lane. if you have any issues with your payment systems, like bills not accepting, check your change machine first and make sure you have an adequate amount of coins available. Make sure that you've primed your changer properly and that your control board has an accurate count of your coins. And make sure that your two diagnostic lights on your changer are not flashing. If there's anything going on with your change machine, you won't be able to accept bills. And it's usually something involved with a coin jam or not having enough coins in your coin machine to make proper change so it'll stop accepting bills. If you have any issues with your cooling deck, make sure you check your set point, that that's set up correctly, and that your cooling is enabled and turned on. You can check your relays through the programming to make sure that they are clicking and firing properly. Also, we can turn our power off at the red button. Make sure that our wires are hooked to our relays properly, and make sure that our main refrigeration harness is hooked up underneath the switch. Right now, it is not hooked up for the testing process. So again, this is Vince Graves, tech advisor here at Sega Manufacturing. If you have any issues specifically or questions about products and accessories and what you need to vend properly, don't hesitate to call us here at Sega. You can talk to our customer care support, or you can use my contact information below to contact me specifically. Thank you for your time.